So they're split in half, like usual. One thing I've noticed is this side has a lot of these guys that have the rush, whatever you call it, interception. So he's going to be able to disengage. So we can't really tie these guys up. I don't want them running through our lines. So we'll have to try something a little different. I think what I'd like to do is probably slow this guy, maybe throw some mud on this side. Not quite sure. Yeah, let's start over here. There we go. So we can hit them both. All right, now they should not be able to reach. And then the archer is going to do archer things. And we'll have to deal with this guy later, but I think that's fine. Thing is, now he's going to get engaged on this side, but only by this guy in the front. Actually, you know what we should do is we should run and then throw something down like this. That might block those two. I don't know. Maybe it won't block this guy. We'll try it anyways. All right, this guy's moving next, and this is the problem one. Because again, he can rush through a lot of that stuff. So we'll go ahead and throw some mud down. It's not going to do a lot, but... And then we'll also throw a barrage down. I think he's going to be able to... I think he's going to get through it. Yeah, see, that's... I mean, I was kind of nervous about staying on this side, but what can you do? All right, see if we can take out the sapper. I don't know if we can, but... All right, that was a good hit. God, it's not enough. They got too much health. Yeah, I don't think we can do much about it. All right, no worries. Let's go back. We'll throw a heal down on Jammo. All right, next up is their sapper. Can we reach? Yes, we can. All right, so Phil Johnson's going to go in first. All right, beautiful. Now we got to worry about everything on this side. This is going to be the tough part. This guy, oh, he just does no damage. Well, we're doing pretty good damage, at least with barrage. Man, it's just not really cut. Wow, he took a lot of damage. I don't know what that second one was for. Oh, corrosion, got it. Does he have something that causes corrosion? What, maybe it was... Oh, applies to corrosion and poison, got it. Interesting. It's probably been there the whole time and I just finally realizing it. Oh, we gotta do something quick here. Let's push this guy back. It's not gonna be enough. Yeah, he's still gonna be in range. But it's not gonna do too much, though. Well, let's try and pick people off as we can. I don't really know what else we can do besides that. Yeah, we're not really in a good position to barrage too much in here. Oh man, they're ignoring. Should have thought of that. Alright, we just gotta pick people off as we can. Alright, luckily these guys don't really do much damage, so we can mostly focus on the other people, I think. Right, we can get three hits on this one. A single point of damage, what the heck? Well, that's far from ideal, but what can you do? Alright, Tibbers is tanking pretty well in there. And then we'll just keep barraging. I think we kind of have to get out of this. I don't know if run negates it. Oh, wow. That's an insane amount of damage. Well, we won't be doing that again. Alright, this was a waste, unfortunately. So let's go do the same thing. We can kite both of these guys, actually. With just one. So we do get some efficiency out of that. Yeah, he's not going to be able to go anywhere. Now we'll also get... Yep, a little more mud. Poor archer. We got to do something down here because that's a lot of people. We're going to be taking a lot of damage on our frontliners. You know what? Let's just do this. I don't know if this is a bad idea or not, but we're going to do it anyways. All right, that's enough to get the kill. And then we can back out. So at least we don't have to deal with the archer. That was kind of my main goal with that. And we put a little bit of damage. I didn't really feel like there's a good opportunity in here. So let's try and get some hits here. All right, we'll proc two hits from that. He takes no damage at all. It's crazy. Oh boy, that's really bad. Let's give him a kick. Let's push him off. He's going to take two hits for that. And then we just need to get out. We're on willpower at this point. All right, he's going to take two more hits. He is just such a tank. All right, we need a big hit here. A single point of damage again. We can get a big hit here. Nope, apparently not. That did almost nothing. Yeah, I think we're just going to have to barrage these guys down. Yeah, the only thing we have going for us is this left side can't really do much. but we're getting clobbered pretty badly on this. They're just really, really strong is the problem. All right, let's get some hits on this guy. Oh, hit the wrong guy. We have to barrage. Oh, he's gonna bypass. Another barrage. Why is he only doing one damage? I'm a little confused on that. That's not good. I didn't want to disengage. And there's another spear wall that just got wasted. I think the strategy here is to actually just go close to melee range and just do it like that. So let's... I was gonna say we can come here, but we won't be able to get an attack off. If we do it like this, we'll get three. That's fine. All right, there's one. All right, we're gonna do something very, very risky, but we kind of have to. So we'll draw him in. Hopefully bait them into attacking that. I think we should try and get a few more hits. Alright, there's two more. Alright, Peter Bond can get in there. I don't know if it's enough to kill, though. That's the concern. It's fine. Let's go for it. Oh yeah, he does a lot of damage. Only one to that guy for some reason. That's not enough to kill, so let's go ahead and do another dagger. There we go, now we can get it. I don't think we want a frenzy, though. That seems like a waste. So we'll just back out again. Alright, here we go. Yeah, he does no damage anyways, it's fine. Oh, he's gonna heal. Oh, because he had deflection, that's why. That makes sense. I think we keep doing the same thing to these. Yeah, we'll just keep delaying. And again, we're able to slow two people with only one of ours. So we're getting some efficiency out of that. Hang in there, Phil. Yeah, he's doing a good job. He's really, really tanky. Unfortunately, they're moving outside of the range of our barrage. So we'll move our barrage up a little bit. All right, we'll cancel that, and I think we're going to do it this time. Oh, that actually burned through. That's really good. I didn't think about that. So the deflection works for a certain amount of attacks. Because this attacks four times, it burns the deflection pretty fast. Yeah, that's pretty good. Don't think we really want to get in there any further, actually. I think we've got that under control. Yeah, we're going to have to cancel these pretty much no matter what we do. So let's get in here. Let's get two hits. Oh, he's dead. Oh, man, he's almost dead just from the poison. We're not going to deal with him yet, though. Let's get rid of this archer. All right, he's dead. Nice. All right, we're going to survive this one. Not by much, but we are going to survive. Oh, there's another one down. So only three left. I don't expect this to be too difficult, so I'll probably edit the rest out, but if anything interesting happens, I will let you know. So let's, we can use these guys to heal each other up. Maybe we can avoid the injury. Well, I'm an idiot, and I forgot to attack in the right order. So this guy got in and hit our archer. Yeah, we're just all messed up this fight. Definitely not peak performance, but we're gonna win it. I was a little concerned that this would actually be a loss, and we're hanging in there. Alright, one more down, so two left. Alright, one left. So what I'm doing is, I set up plenty of mud, and I'm using Jesse Bogart with a slow. We're using the archers to farm temporary valor points, and we're just spamming heals everywhere, so we don't have to deal with it. But Tipper's back to full health. Forsaken, pretty much back to full health. We got two more people. You can barely even make it to the mud, let alone get through it. So we should be fine healing everybody up. Right, Bones and Malone back to full health as well. Looks like everybody's pretty much at full health. We got one more, and then Lulu Cole will be full. All right, there we go. Jesse Bogart did the honors. So we didn't have to use any healing. We're gonna have to do some pretty heavy repairs though. But that worked out quite well. A lot of levels too. You know, fighting those tough battles, it seems like you get a lot more XP, which makes sense. So unfortunately, Phil Johnson, we're gonna have to get him up really high with willpower if we want to overcome the deficit that he's already got. And to be honest, it's probably worth it. It's probably worth it. He's a frontliner. It's really, really crappy to have to do that, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, I forgot. We also got level 8, so we get to pick a perk. So guard break. So attacks dealt ignore 50% of the enemy's guard. That's really good. That would have come in handy in that last battle. After taking 2 attacks, you get deflection. That's not bad. And then one-on-one unit has rivalry, which damage taken dealt by engaged opponent reduced by 50%. Yeah, so as long as there's nobody else crowd in the area, takes less damage. I don't like that one quite as much. I feel like it's not going to be as useful. And we're not really using him as a damage dealer, so I feel like Temperance is probably the pick here, going along the lines of being really, really strong. So every 2 hits, he'll get deflection. And he already gets protection. Yeah, he's really strong. All right, so that's Phil Johnson. Let's check out Jammo. We got a repair. Luluko also repair and level 8. So there's 4 options here. So preparedness, if the unit ends a turn while not engaged in combat, they gain fury. So next attack increased by 50%. Very, very rarely are they going to be engaged in combat. So this is actually quite good. Harnessing strength is damage increased by 5%. For each bonus applied, I don't think that one's all that great. Yeah, I don't like stacking that type of stuff. All right, last push, we get rage. Really, this one's only good if they have a bunch of debuffs. Damage increased by 5% for each debuff. Yeah, it's kind of silly. So when this unit kills an enemy engaged in combat with an ally, unit and the other ally gain dodge. So they completely dodge 1 attack. Again, it's kind of an interesting perk. I don't think it's the right call, though. I think preparedness is probably the right one. This one would be applied more often than anything else, but just based on the builds that we're going for. So I think that's the right call. And critical hit, up to 26 now. And Bones and Malone needs a lot of repairs. And same thing with Tibbers. There we go. So we're back in good shape. A couple of new levels. Got level 8 armor. Oh man, 124. All right, let's take a look and see how this armor stacks up. It's a lot more armor. It's less guard. You don't get the strength because there's no inserts. But it's a pretty big upgrade. I mean, going from level 5 to level 8, it's not too surprising. It just sucks they don't have any inserts. All right, let's see. I think everybody's going to have pretty much the same, so it's going to be about the same across the board. But the medium armor, this is 25 more armor and more carry capacity. You lose the critical hit, though. Yeah, I think it's worth it. What about Jesse Bogart? Oh, he's not level 8. Yep, only Luluko. So with this one, more guard, more armor, carry capacity, less critical hit. I mean, the biggest consideration here is that they generally don't take a lot of damage to begin with because they're mostly people in the back. Carry capacity is irrelevant. So is that 5 critical hit worth the extra 25 armor? Yeah, I think it is. Okay, we'll leave it at that. And I don't think we're going to switch the armor, the heavy armor. The guard is pretty nice. The strength is pretty nice to have. Although this one gives critical hit damage. That would be pretty good on one of the heavy damage dealers like Bones. I feel like Bones would be able to take advantage of this. But less guard, that's a huge difference. Oh, can't use it yet. That's why. Okay, never mind. Yeah, I think we'll run with this. I think that's a good plan. All right, Rick Walker wants to have a chat. Let's go aptitude point. Come on. Nope, no aptitude point. But there's some pretty good options in here. We got 420 XP or better relations. So he's at 165. So it's basically 420 would be 10%. So you get about 10% of a level. It's not bad. I'm curious if it adds XP to Bones Malone too. So 1007, let's see. Let's take that one. 1007... 1406, yeah, it does actually. Oh, so Bones gets the XP. Actually, not Rick Walker. So it's the person that suggested it. That makes sense. Which is good, actually, because Bones is level 7. Needs to catch up, so that'll help quite a bit. Now we've got... Yeah, we're not going to do the hard quest. There's no way we can handle that right now. We can probably do the Montague gang, though. So we can handle these guys. Now, I don't think we can get down here regularly, so we're going to have to PTAW. A little bit of finagling required. Level 8s, this shouldn't be too bad. Yeah, we can handle level 8. I like the idea of attacking these guys first, but unfortunately the setup is not good. So we're going to have to go for these. There is so much poison around. Holy cow. We'll probably go back there and engage the poacher, I think, with Peter Bond. So, but we don't have to worry about that just yet. They are moving this poacher. Oh, they have a lot of archers. That's fine. Let's actually get our archer a little further back out of harm's way. And I think what we'll do is we'll start targeting these guys first. That is a huge hit. All right, there's one down. All right, we got plenty of armor, so no big deal on that. Let's continue the theme here. Oh, you know what? Actually, Yep, I think this way so we don't actually knock him out of range. Ooh, I did not consider that. Alright, let's run to disengage. Let's go beat this guy up. Now let's see if we can pick off this archer. We might be able to. We do quite a bit of damage. No, it's not enough. It's pretty good damage. Oh wow. Peter Bond's gonna get... He's gonna get meleeed down by an archer. That's kind of funny, kind of sad. Let's get some more valor points back here. Oh, it's not enough. Well, we can run. Oh man, he just bypassed everybody. I don't know what's going on. I'm just not thinking this through. Yeah, it's not like I'm going too fast. I'm just, my brain's just not working very well right now. Okay, no worries. Let's focus a little bit better. So we'll start by getting rid of this guy. That was a little underwhelming, but... Alright, there we go. So that guy's gone, the ranger. I'm not too worried about these guys over here. I mean, the archer maybe a little bit, but not really. Let's go ahead and engage this wrongdoer guy. Wow. Critical hit for 5 damage. What the heck? Ooh, man. So we got a good hit, but it didn't really stop him. Alright, we'll get a second hit now. Hopefully. Oh, it didn't push him. Why? Sometimes it pushes and sometimes it doesn't. I'm not quite sure. I should probably read that a little closer. Oh, it's only on critical hits. Well, there you go. That makes a little bit more sense. Now, Peter Bunn is struggling a little bit, so let's try and finish this guy real quick. There we go. And we'll keep him kind of close by. He might be able to help support. I think we can... Yeah, I was going to say, I think we can take out that archer. And we'll keep delaying this guy a bit. Alright, they're getting really close, so we need to start doing something about that. So let's throw some mud down. Alright, not too worried about bones. Yeah. All the extra damage. Yeah, we'll keep pushing him back. So let's actually get some heal. Alright, we're looking to finish this guy. Yeah, that's perfect. And then we can actually shove this guy back as well. Man, that's so nice. Yeah, let's actually get our heal off. I don't think we need to rush. We can probably just push this guy back a little bit. Oh, or kill him. Alright, there's another one down. And we need to start healing up Peter Bond. He's in real rough shape right now. Oh, he's gonna get hit. Crap. Yeah, he's gonna push him into the poison. But we'll stay here and commit to taking out that archer. I don't think we need to do anything too crazy. We'll get a hit on both. He's got so much poison. And let's actually cure. Take the archer out first. And then we'll go back and try and heal up. Oh, wow. Yeah, Lazy Law's tearing it up. We need to get the heal on these guys. That's what... I think we'll start stealing those again. Oh. 85 damage from one tick of poison. I guess he had 8 stacks. But before we end, we should probably try and heal everybody. Alright, we'll let the mosquitoes chow on this guy. Keep pushing this guy back while we heal up. Right, Peter Bones back to full health. Get a couple archers up here. They're not really missing much though, so don't need to worry about that. Yeah, this poor guy's getting chewed up. Mosquitoes, poison, push back. Yeah, he's dead. Alright, so that was pretty successful. We lost a lot of armor, but it's nothing a few dollars can't fix. We got level 7 armor. It's heavy armor, so it's not going to work. Now, I would like to do a little exploring around here, but problem is we're kind of low on a lot of things, so I think we'll just head back. Let's throw another piton up. This seems like a good spot for it. Alright, we got a rest to eat soon, so let's not get caught. Right, we did a lot of missions, a lot of quests, 3 of them, so we just made another 1,000. Now, let's accept quest. We won't do it yet, but we'll at least take it. Yeah, we'll have to go further into explore for that one, but this should be good for now. Alright, we're gonna sell all the armor. I'm tempted to use that warbow. It looks pretty good. We got a Legion Pylum. Functional duo deals some damage to the target if engaged in combat. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to use that one. I think we'll keep what we have. So we'll just sell it. But we can do the bard minigame. Let's do that. I was just about to say this one's not too bad. Should have kept my mouth shut. That one went pretty well. And now we became an apprentice, so increases the reward for each song. That's kind of nice. And it also gives us plus one willpower, plus two constitution, so it goes up a little bit. I don't really want to rest and use the food. Let's just do... we'll pay for one. And we need to get to the blacksmith. We are hurting for that, so let's go over to the Yelba clan. We need to take care of this first. The tombs of the ancient. What are we supposed to do? It's not in here. Not on the market. I don't see anybody lighting up here. What are we supposed to do here? Let's drop some stuff off. I'm not sure what we're supposed to do in this place.
A chest. Are you ready to travel?
Okay, nothing in there. What am I missing? I'm not sure. Well, I'm sure it'll pop up once we figure it out. So we probably need to head up here in this region to uncover more things. And then there's a chunk up here that we missed. It says there's more down here, but I know this is all blocked off, so I guess maybe it's somewhere down here. Let's head south. Now, I thought this was the edge of the map. I remember coming down here, I thought, and it just stops. So this will probably be where a new region unlocks. Yeah, so you can't get to it from there. I was pretty sure that there's no way to get back here. I guess maybe you can use a Pitaw. Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah, you can't get down from this side either. So we might be getting trolled here by the devs. Because it doesn't look like you can get back there. Yeah, this is completely separated. All right, we fully explored this stuff. So I don't think there's anything else in here. This is a pretty bad spot to rest. Just remember what we were supposed to do. All these red shield signs. We're supposed to go to the blacksmith. So let's do that before we fight. Oh, wow, that's a lot. What the heck? Look how many people that is. Whoa. That is a lot. That's like, I don't know, 50, 60, probably more. Now, I realized on the map it said find soldier. And I was looking through some of these scenes. I see this guy right here cowering. Lieutenant Gutshalk. I think it might be him. Scholar said we could make it. Wait, what happened to our chains? I think we have them in storage somewhere. Yeah, right there. It's fine. We'll pay the 50 bucks. All right, there we go. Now we can take him captive. Scholar said we could. So he's now following the group and we can go deliver straight north. Oh, wait. So we got to choose. We take this soldier to the professor or to the Ludern judges. So he escaped from the judges, which means if we take him back here, he's dead. If we take him back here, he's okay. All right, let's go back to the professor, I think. And we need to stop by the blacksmith. Yeah, here we go. Here's a piece. And we'll buy some more raw materials. We're running pretty low there. And I think we'll spend some time smithing in the near future. I think we should probably do that. So the rim steel stuff requires level 8, and we are halfway. I think maybe half of us. Yeah, not quite. Probably about 40% are at level 8. Oh, nice. We can sing here, too. Let's just keep getting XP. Right, we got a roast ball, so we can sell that. Yeah, worth another 8. They actually make pretty good money doing that. And let's see. So 15 a pop. Actually, it might have been more. I didn't see what it was that time. But we only did it once since we became an apprentice, and we're already halfway there. So it seems like it levels okay. The tricky one is when you get to the very end. That last level is pretty brutal. All right, let's go drop this guy off. So if we give her 20 mosquito probiosis, we get a bog thunder. Don't know what that is. Looks like a hammer, but it also looks like it could be a fly swatter. So I don't know if it's an item or a weapon. We'd have to go back, to our travel post and then recall those in. So we might do that. Now, I don't think we're quite yet ready for the champion. The tournament arena. So we'll hold off on that. Foul smell, let's get rid of this one. All right, Jilly wants to have a chat. Hopefully it's about his singing. Yeah, 16 XP as a bard's basically useless. Let's go relations with close companions. Now, there's a quest or mission we got to do that's really close. It's not these guys, though. Let's skip it. Turn these people in real quick. Oh, we want to fight that, though. We'll come back and do that because that's going to be another one of the reinforcements. The bandit slayer. We don't want to deal with that. Here we go. Here's the professor. So we get 10 Alzarian powder, some money. Nice. So that's 2 out of the 5. We got 3 more to go. And then we'll have this area knocked out. Now let's check the Ludern stables. I think we did that when we first came in here, but didn't really figure out what quest or whatever it is we're supposed to get done here. Oh, that's right. This is the one the guy wanted 9,000. Going to 9,000 influence. Or we get this torque. So I think we're not able to do that just yet. Actually, no, I forgot. They got some wood here being cut. Haven't done that in a while. Actually, this place doesn't seem to have a whole lot of stations for this. So we need to go somewhere else. You know what? Yeah, let's just take these guys out. Yeah, we need to. We're here. They've got three archers back here, but not really a good spot to set up because then you're getting sandwiched between the two. Whereas if we start back here, we can get just about everybody on one side. Actually, Peter Bon, since he's got infinite movement speed, pretty much. And you know what we'll do? Yeah, let's start it like this. We'll move Peter Bon first. Let's target two people that are somewhat squishy. Yeah, we'll start it right here. Yeah, it's not going to be enough. I was hoping we'd get in range of Wrath, but that's not going to work. So we are going to back up. All right, Wrongdoer's going first, so let's go ahead and throw some mud his way. And then we'll mostly just have to deal with the front couple people. Yeah, he's not going anywhere. All right, we can hit all three here. This is going to be good. Now, I wonder if I can hit another three for one. Yeah, we can. So much damage. All right, this guy's not going to be able to reach, I don't think. Yeah, he's just shy. But we'll go ahead and give him a gentle nudge backwards. And we'll just keep being really annoying. There's another one down. Now, I don't think I really want to get anybody in melee range, so let's just keep backing up. We can always just create a front line with the shields. There's another one down. Now, I'd like to try and start working on these archers. Yeah, we'll use aim. And we'll just keep falling back. Let's actually use Peter Bon. Get some more poison on this guy so we can chip away at him. Alright, where's Jammo? We need to get some more mud going here. Actually, we'll pick on the weak guy. Five damage, wow. Remus, what's going on? Let's get another set of mud down. We'll get it a little further back so we can hit all four. No crit on that, but that archer's almost dead. I think one more hit, we'll get him. Yep, he's gonna be toast. This is like the perfect scenario for our build. They literally can't even get close. And then when they do get in range, they're just a little bit shy, but we're close enough to where we can kind of run in there, pick at them, and run back. All right, we'll hit both of them. Yeah, I don't think anybody's really going to be running into the barrage, so let's not do that. Peter Bon is ready to go. We're going to do something a little crazy here. Really, really long distance. We'll take a little bit of poison. And then we'll back out. So he just soloed two people. That's kind of nice. Phil Johnson cleaning up. Yeah, he's still not going to be in range. So we should just be able to pick the rest off. I'm going to edit the rest of this up. Man, this thing is so good with aim. It has such a big range. And we got five stacks of rage from that. Alright. Yeah, Archer's dead. They got one guy left. I'll clean this up. Ooh, man. Got a good crit in the end on that one. So that was that. Jammo gained a level. Very, very good to see that. I was wondering, she should have been up first, but I guess we were using Mudsling. Maybe it doesn't give as much XP. Now, again, this one, I still feel like Rage, Thrill of the Hunt is the better pick here. More crit. So 38. And that was not the quest that we have to do. It's actually over here further. Oh, are they up the mountain? How do we get up there? Oh, it's actually these right here. Okay, I saw a bunch of animals and I assumed that was something else, but looks like it's this one. This should be pretty easy, so again, I'll probably edit this out, but let's take a quick look. Yeah, they seem decent enough. We did get an ambush on them though, so they're going to be taking a huge amount of damage. Yeah, you know what, this shouldn't be too bad, but we still have to be cautious. Let's throw some mud down. Oh, and Jammo got the rage going. So just from that one shot, got two stacks of rage. So that means she does 10% more damage. Now I'm tempted to get a hit in here. I think we can do it, and then we can run if we absolutely have to. Yeah, that should be pretty good. He's still in range. Yeah, let's just do it. Let's just be a little bit safe. Oh, I didn't see the trap till I had already clicked. Whoops. Oh, this is going to be really nice. Look how many people are lined up for this. Can we hit four? No, it's just a little bit off. It's alright, we'll hit three. Right, that bear's going to have infinite movement speed here. Luckily, he's going over the mud. Yeah, he's got 900 health, though. That's not going to be too fun. Oh, this is perfect. How many can we hit? Only two. What? Let's reposition. We got to be able to at least hit three. Yeah, there we go. Pretty good damage on that. Now, I'd like to take out all these guys so we can just focus on the bear all at once. All right, they're kind of lined up again. I think we can hit three. Yeah, man. Killed two out of the three with that. And let's get some poison stacks on the bear. Oh, or not. Yeah, there it goes. Yeah, it's not really going to make sense to attack the bear until we get rid of all the humans. That heal is just brutal. Now, we can delay the bear, though. So we can definitely do that. And we'll bait him into here. Alright, that's all of them. Now it's just a couple animals. Right, we should be able to stop him here with the spear. Yeah, we're going to want to get a lot more damage on him, though. Actually, you know what we could do? We can give him a nice little kick. Yeah, push him back. Oh, I thought he was going to get hit by the spear wall. Interesting. All right, we can save it for the next round. And this thing's probably got a ton of strength. Yeah, so I think Phil Johnson's not going to get too much damage in with only 36. So we'll let him skip. Now, before the bear gets his turn in, we definitely want to get some poison on this. Yeah, get another stack. You know what? We can get another poison stack. Yeah, five. He's pretty much dead on the next turn. Oh, that's not what I wanted. How come it didn't push him back? It's supposed to be 100%. All right, well, let's prep to get smashed here. one thing we can do... Well, no, it's not going to do much good. Either way, we'll hit him. Oh man, it went right through Berserk. It did 200 and something damage. All the poison stacks that we had. Alright, these are level 7 armor. Probably gonna pass. I don't think it's gonna be good enough. There we go, so that's done.